What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to another video. As you can tell by the title and the thumbnail, we're gonna be doing a story time. This crazy, y'all, one of the many crazy story times I had to tell from my high school years. When I tell you high school was so crazy, I don't recommend it. I'm gonna be doing some jumbo braids over my locks. I've already retwisted, washed, and oiled them and stuff. They're prepped and ready to just go ahead and braid. Anyway, let's get to this story time. Okay, so this was the year of whenever it was that I was in high school, ninth grade. And I was on the volleyball team. And yeah, I already just wasn't the most popular person in school. Didn't nobody like me, and did I care? No. But it was just the fact that it made high school just so much more annoying. I had a few friends, but for the most part, a lot of people didn't. During this time, the beginning of high school will be like the best days I will ever come to have in high school. I wouldn't say a lot of people liked me, but nobody had a problem with me. I was just living my life until this one volleyball game. So like I said, I played volleyball, right? So I was at a game and it was varsity that was playing, and coach had asked me to play because I wasn't in varsity. I was only in the ninth grade. Coach had asked me to play, but I didn't have my uniform. So I ended up just sitting, you know, in the bleachers and just chilling while the rest of the game was going on. And during that time, I had met somebody. And after we was just like making jokes, talking or whatever, along with a group of people, he sent somebody for me to come find me because he wanted to talk to me. That was the thing that boys did up in high school. When they like somebody, instead of coming to them for themselves, they gonna send somebody and be like,
"Hey, my homeboy wants you. What's up?"
No, it's just how we look at high school. So obviously, somewhere down the line, one of his homeboys kept asking me, and I eventually say yes, obviously, because we're here. We ended up going like off and on, real toxic. Now, all throughout this time of us being toxic through ninth grade, because we met towards the beginning of the school year, he's entertaining other females like real bad. And when I say real bad, I mean real bad. Like 4 or 5 different people, and I done caught him multiple times at this point, texting other females, all this other stuff. And you know what I do? Miss Dumpy Locks comes skipping right back like a fool. This lasted our whole relationship, but y'all, it starts getting mind-blowing in 10th grade, because like, it was normal for you to cheat on me with females. My niggas too. Alright, so boom. We in the 10th grade and we like a year and so much in. He'll have like these girl best friends and he'll be telling me, "Oh, they just friends, and that's where they always get you at. That's where they always get you at, because they always say we just friends and they don't ever be just friends." Yeah, he just basic friends, I guess, with other girls, and like word getting around that he's a little whore, okay? Everybody know he's a hoe. He goes around real easy. Anybody can get to him, right? But me, being the fool I was in high school, I was like, you know, as long as he know where home is.
Wait a damn minute.
As long as he know where home is.
Bitch, I know you fucking not.
Yes, y'all. I was one of them. I can never see it today, but yes, I was one of them. All through 10th grade, he got these little scandalous rumors with other girls, and I actually ended up like getting into it. Like, once I met him and like started being in a relationship with him, people started hating me, like making up random rumors about me that was not true, and just giving me a whole lot of unwanted attention, all because I was talking to him. And y'all, really, come to find out, he started helping the rumors, but that's just a whole nother thing. Like, that's just, like, this relationship curates 3 story times on its own, over 3 story times on its own, besides this story I'm telling right now. It was a very eventful relationship. So then it get out that he got this video with a dude. And y'all, at this time, we was actually on one of our breaks, but we were still together. We just was on a break. And I'm like, you know, that wasn't a little different. If you want to go mess with other females, go do that, you know? Because I had me a little side something, too, for when he never got the acting right and when we were going on little breaks. I just call him a little side something, you know what I'm saying? But never, never at the same time. That's besides the point. The point is, I was minding my business with my liaison, and then people started telling me that. And so then, you know, of course, they like, dang, what you do to him to make him want to go gay? And I'm like, wait a minute now. Because, like, at this point, y'all, we ain't even done nothing like that. You know what I'm saying? And I was really trying to get on my top because he was DL. And I'm like, hold on, wait a minute. We ain't finna do me like that. I came up to him and I asked him, I said, what's going on? Like, where is this coming from? And he denied it and denied it and denied it. So of course, me being me, that was my man, and I chose to stick beside him.
This is your man?
Yes.
Look at the screen.
That's mine.
And that's what you're going to settle for.
I chose to stick beside him. So you know what? At this point, can I really blame anybody other than myself? People being people, high schoolers being high schoolers, they coming up to me asking me, like, did you hear about what happened to so-and-so? Like, is it true? Like, and I'm like, nah, baby, that couldn't be true because he was with me the whole time that they saying this happened. It was like, they never said when it happened, so how you know that he wasn't doing stuff behind your back? And I'd be like, yo, this is so crazy. I literally stood by the story that, like, oh, we be at each other's house all the time, or we always on the phone. He has no time to sneak around. And the fact that I knew I was lying made me question it, because I'm like, bro, if he really didn't do it, why am I having to lie to defend him? And y'all, after that, I just started looking back over our relationship. And I remember, like, this one time, his best friend, y'all, so I had tried to kill myself. If y'all want to retire, y'all can get it. It's not funny. It's a very serious mental health crisis. It's not funny. But I had overdosed and I was unconscious in the hospital for like 3 days. And you know, it was sad. It wasn't looking good for me. And I wasn't gonna make it there for a second. And he on the phone like crying. Somebody took a screenshot of him crying, his girl best friend, and sent it to him and was like, girl, look how bad he missed you. This dude really over here crying over you, blah, blah, blah. I saw this when I got out of the hospital. And y'all, this was like a little bit before this, like this was way back in ninth grade when this happened, and all of this stuff is coming out in like 10th grade, so a whole year later. But I remember, like, she sent the screenshot and he was crying and his tears was black, and I'm like, bro, he had on mascara. Like, I didn't really pay no attention to it then, but now that I remember, he did. And then it was this one time I had went up to him in the hallway and I was like, yo, eyelashes are so pretty, and I touched his eyelashes and they were hard. As if he had on mascara. So as time goes on, people, like, when they hear his name, you know, you think of all he messing with dude, but like, it had kind of blew over, but then it had kind of didn't. And so I guess they just forgot, and like, we kind of forgot about the whole situation, right? Wrong. So the summer going into the 11th grade, him and my best friend was in a little something, and I didn't know till his girl best friend had told me by accident, because she was going around telling people that I had already knew, but I didn't. So I contacted her like, yo, you messing with my dude? And she was like, yeah, I already told you that, like, I thought you knew. She kept trying to convince me to leave him alone. And I thought it was weird, but then when I figured that out, when I was told that, I was like, oh, That's why you want me gone so bad. She had made me so mad. I was like, yeah, boo, it's on site. What you mean? It's not even the fact that you messing with my dude. It's just the fact that you want to go around telling people that I knew and we still friends. Like, you're really coming for my character at that point. But of course, as immature females do, I blamed her instead of him. And I cut her off, ready to fight her, but I was still messing with him. 11th grade was when it all came to the surface. Now, all through 10th grade, people was just talking. It was never no proof. Yeah, he was friends with the girls, and I'm pretty sure they was texting and people saw they text messages. But me personally, I never saw it. So it was just speculations to me. I was basically just trying to find a reason to be a fool for longer than I had to. Because, baby, I knew. I saw the red flag. I knew he was Sheena. I just didn't care. I just didn't have enough self-respect for myself to care. Proof never went or came to me because I never even asked for it. I did go through his phone one time and I found him texting somebody. But other than that one time, like as far as it go with all the multiple people, it was always just talk, drama, gossip. I knew what it was like to be lied on and so many people believe it. So, you know, without hard down proof, I never believed it. Well, I never acted on it. I believed it. I knew it was true, but I didn't act on it unless I had proof. But I never went seeking hard down proof because, honestly, I didn't want to know. I didn't want to break it off with him. So I didn't want to put it in my face like that, if I'm going to be real with myself. We enter into 11th grade, and y'all, that's when I found out about his girl best friend. Like I said, he was messing around on me all summer long, and I didn't find out until the end of summer. So the end of summer came, y'all, and this is how I got the best friend caught up in it, because she caught her own self up. This was the first piece of evidence that she's ever like presented to where I would think like, dang, something right here. Apparently his mama, the dude mama, had went through his phone, texted all the girls that he was messing around with and was like, hey, he messing around, he nasty, and I'm getting him checked, and I just wanted to let y'all know that y'all need to get checked too because he's been going around real bad. And I didn't get the message because we had stopped messing with each other like after 2 weeks into the summer. Not even 2 weeks. Maybe 1 week into the summer, we had completely just like, we was on one of them super duper long breaks. And so when she sent this message out, I wasn't on his roster at the time. But his best friend apparently got the message and sent it to me. If she went through his phone to see who all she had to text, why did she feel the need to text you? Something's a little odd. That would have told me to run then and there. But did I? No. Instead, I was like, okay. And then I went on about my day. Fast forward to when we actually in 11th grade. He done got caught up all in his mess. Everybody know his business all in the street. It's his 12th grade year. I'm pretty sure it was the worst year of his high school life. Because at this point, everything is out. Everybody knows that he's burning. He done infested some people, and he was messing around a little too bad, like 2-3 people in a night, one night bad. This man is dangerous. He's a danger to society, and everybody know at this point. 11th grade year, with him being shunned by everybody, and just like this horrible outcast, I ain't have no problem not fooling with him. Like, I done got another serious relationship, done got my heart broke by somebody else, completely different, couldn't get over him. Oh, dude, best friend, the girl best friend, right? She telling me some tea. I think it was before a basketball game or something, but she's still best friends with him. And at this point, she my only friend. So she in the hallway telling me somebody how his mama, old dude mama, found a video of him and a girl in his stuff and decided to text the girl and was like, I know that's you, like we need to talk because he got something and you probably got it. And as the girl was telling me this, she said that his mama sent it to her And I'm like, so if she clearly saw the face that was in the video, why did she send it to you? Telling me like it wasn't me. I don't know why she's sending it to me, but she said she saw the face and everything. Like, if she saw the face and everything, she's sending it to you because she know you're the girl from the video. What do you mean? Like, why are you sitting here trying to claim me? Like, I'm just stupid. When she told me when this was, it was around the time that we was together and she was his girl best friend. And like, she was trying to play matchmaker with us and everything. She was all in my face acting like she was cool and like we was just such a cute couple and everything. And whole time, she messing around with him, y'all. Whole time. So everybody know about this video with him and his other girl. And that's like what everybody is talking about. And me, like, I'm in a whole nother thing. I'm just hearing a 10. I'm like, And so then, y'all remember the video rumors from 10th grade? Nobody ever saw the video, but people were speaking of the video, and they finally dropped the video. They airdropped it to a bunch of random people in school. Him with a dude. Y'all done ran out of here. This where we at so far. But anyway, this video, within 2.5 seconds, the whole school had the video. Even though I was off minding my business, people was coming to me telling me like, hey, like, did you this, that, and the third. And I'm like, bro, are you serious? And I never saw the video, but it was out there. And then there was multiple dudes started coming out with like text message, screenshots, and they own videos. It was multiple videos and they all got, well, some of them got around. Yeah, it was crazy. Like, everybody was like, oh my God, like this dude really done got exposed. And I kind of was like, dang, I stuck up for him. But then again, it was like, Chad ain't got nothing to do with me. Because he was fighting that demon well before I opened my body up to him. So it was just like, it couldn't have been me. You feel me? Yeah, that's how that happened. Multiple girls, including two of my best friends. Multiple dudes. One of the dudes I was actually super duper duper cool with. I guess he did a thing for my friends. That's why I don't have them. That's why I don't want them right there. The sad part about it is, I didn't stop completely messing with him until way into the summer going into 12th grade. He had to go to this military camp because he was going to the military. And it was like boot camp or whatever. He couldn't have his phone for like 8 weeks. And like in that time, without him speaking to me and like tainting my mind, I began to like just think and use my common sense. And I said, yeah, it's over. It should have been over a long time ago. And I finally just cut him off for good and ain't thought about him since then. High school was a wild time. I'm gonna just finish up tomorrow. I just hate how nappy my dreads are. Like, they cute when they out, but when I try to put them in braids, like the fuzzies really be out, but it's fine. It makes it look more indigenous, I guess, because it's like you can see the dreads and you can see the texture of my dreads through the braids. But then again, it don't blend with the braid in here. So is it tacky or is it cute? That's how they are so far. I really like how you can see my grid through my braids. That's how long they are. It's giving. I think I like it. I just finished braiding my hair. I don't know how I feel about it. I hate how I do everybody else's hair so nice, and when it comes to my hair, I just feel like it don't be giving, like, for real. But y'all see how nappy the roots is? I don't know. It's rubbing me the wrong way. All right, y'all. I'm actually gonna go somewhere. That's why I'm looking different. I just got done dipping my hair, but I do gotta make my final touches. I'll show y'all the final results. It be feeling so good on my scalp. These are the final results of my braids. I just like my hair being done without liking it or not. But I really do like this grid. You know what I'm saying? I like it. I like the braids. It's just like, oh no, my dress looking a little nappy. But anyway, if y'all enjoyed this story time while I was doing my hair look concept, then let me know down in the comments. And I definitely get on this and we can make this a little thing. Like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. And God bless.